trying to do something really different here, which is to bring together two different generations of primarily female leaders. What they all have in common is a close back and forth learning and teaching relationship. I think it's so interesting that the idea that there are coaches and there are mentors and there are advisors, like what's the difference?
Well, generally when you're mentoring, you're telling your lessons learned. If someone's asking you, you might make suggestions about different routes or options you might want to take. Whereas when you're a coach, you're listening, you're helping that person find the answers to their own questions.
In my case, you know, Cheryl helped me build my business and tripled the number of clients. It was basically, teach me, tell me how you did this and how does it apply to my goals and where I want to be in my business.
The current number of female CEOs, I think of Fortune 500 companies, is 3.8%. It really hasn't changed. It's gone up to 5%. You know, I mean, that's kind of where it's at.
All of those of us in power, whether you're a woman or you're a man, you have to be purposeful about it. You have to seek opportunities for people of color, for women. You have to seek that. And when you seek it, you'll be surprised at how much it actually happens.
I think it
starts both ways. It has to come from the top. It also has to come from the bottom.
I meet a lot of young women that just are fearful, right? They're afraid to ask. They're afraid to make a move. They're afraid to take control of their career. And the first step is to not be fearful. Right, to know what your value is.
You're afraid to take risks. You tend to be on, you know, straight line path. And with my relationship with Cheryl showed me that she's gone in a lot of different directions in her career. She's diversified, she's taken risks, and she showed me and coached me on how to do that myself.
Many men probably are more willing to take risks of reaching out to this senior executive, oftentimes because that senior executive is also a male. And, you know, I think women are more comfortable reaching out to other female executives, and there are just less female senior executives to reach out to.
And the more we train each other, that the best talent out there includes everybody, not just the 90% white males, but it's got to include Hispanics, and it's got to include Asians, and it's got to include women. And when we do that, we're gonna find that the performance actually gets better.
We've got to change the numbers. The more realistic we can be when we have events like this, when we get together, of really talking about it, not in a negative way, but what are we going to do about it? And part of that is having all of these qualities that we've discussed tonight and really making them beyond just words. And it's not just up to us, it's up to everybody, anytime. Yeah.